Well, it seems like it's time. It seems like it's time for another unboxing. Another unboxing. Okay. All right. So this one's gonna be a little bit different, a little bit the same. It's gonna be some. It's gonna be a little. It's gonna be a cautionary tale. Okay, a cautionary tale. Cautionary. Look at me. All right. So I got a couple boxes today. I got a couple boxes. I got a big box, a little box, a bigger box, a smaller box. Okay. So I got a couple boxes. Okay. And one of the things that I tried my best to do for everybody that watches this channel, everybody I associate with in this comic book community, is to share my experience with them. And good, bad, the ugly, and everything in between. And this is kind of like one of those in-between kind of situations where there's good, there's ugly, and everything else. So I wanted to kind of like go into a little bit of what I'm opening up. The first box that I'm opening up is from a Whatnot seller. Actually, these are both from Whatnot sellers. And, you know, a lot of the Whatnot people, hey, you go here. Go over here, okay? You go here. You go here. You go here. You stay here while I open this up. Okay? All right. So a lot of the Whatnot vibes have been like very bad lately, as far as like, you know, people not being satisfied with the sellers and et cetera, et cetera. And in a lot of cases, they're right. In a lot of cases, they're wrong. In a lot of cases, no, it's not justified. So I'm going to let you know my experiences as a partial Whatnot seller. You know, I've had the experience of being a buyer and a seller. You know, now I'm going to tell you from a buyer. I got this box from let's open this up. Hold on. Let's open this up. Big box. It shouldn't be so big. Why is this box so big? Okay. So here's the thing. I got this box from a seller called Going Twice Comics. Okay. Now they're a Whatnot. They got a big presence. You don't want to see that. Hey. They got a big presence on the comics, cards, and Funkos and all the bullshit that they sell. Okay. So all right, got it out of there. All right. Big box, one slab in here, okay? One of the gimmicks is they do these mystery boxes and wheel games and all this stuff, which they've been forced to stop recently because of all the new rules that are in Whatnot, which I think is a good thing because there's a lot of scammy stuff happening with those other things. I bought a lot of stuff in the past, and I've tested them out multiple times. Most of the sellers that are on Going Twice Comics, they have no idea what they're selling. No idea. They'll sell you Bronze Age books and tell you that they're Silver Age. They'll sell you Copper Age books and tell you they're Bronze Age. They'll sell you modern books and call them vintage, you know, all kinds of crap that's going on. Everything's grossly overpriced. I kind of figured out a system on how to play their game and kind of make myself whole. So I in the past, I've gotten a whole bunch of stuff, and some of it's good, some of it's complete crap. But while you buy stuff from them, they have a point system, a reward system, where you can accumulate rewards and buy stuff off of the website with your points, okay? So here's the thing. Their point system works with points and reward vouchers that you could only get in increments. So in other words, the highest increment you could get from them is like $100. And I had accumulated, I think, about 175 or something like that. So I was able to cash in those vouchers and try to buy something off the website. One thing about their website is most of this stuff is grossly overpriced and crap. Okay, so you have a thin selection of what you could possibly get. Okay, thin, a very thin selection of what you get. All grossly overpriced. By the way, Whatnot recently said they're folding their shop. Going Twice said they're folding their shop in comics. Big surprise. They're still going to be doing their cringy stuff in cards and Funkos and whatever they do, but not in comics. Why? Because people caught on to their bullshit. Okay, so I went to go look at it. I finally found something that is worth my while on there, which is this. Still overpriced, but I figured with the rewards and paying a little bit of cash, it was worth my while to pick it up. Okay, here's a little thing that I didn't realize. You can't combine your rewards. You can only use one voucher at a time. So I was forced to only using $100 as a voucher. Sucks, but it is what it is. I learned my lesson. Anyway, I had it. I had to figure out how to use it. And I did. I used it. And I got something I've been wanting to get for a while. It's a key. It's a good key. A lot of bubble wrap. Okay. It's a good key. Is it worth what their sticker price was on it? No. But after I took off the $100, I justified it. I said, okay, it's worth my while. So they basically had this at $250 on the site. Took away $100, so it cost me $150 pocket. And I said, you know what? For $150, not bad. And it's all right. I think I did okay. So without further ado, let me show you what I have. I got myself a first Black Knight. It's an Avengers 48. This book was really, 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 really hot. Really hot. During the peak of the Eternals craziness. They did put in an invoice. That's a good thing. On the invoice, it says thank you for shopping with us. Okay, at least it says thank you there. At least they did that right. And that's it. Would I have bought this eventually? Yeah, I would have. Would I got a better deal on it? Totally, in total? Possibly. Probably. I don't think I would have paid more than $200. Maybe $175 to $200. I would have paid for in this grade if I really, really wanted a gun and was willing to pay for it. $150, it's all right. I think it's all right. But here's the thing. I got a whole bunch of extra credits now in like $10 and $20 rewards or vouchers that I really don't know what to do with, you know, because they really got crap on there. And the stuff that's not crap is grossly overpriced. So I don't know what to do with them. So I'm going to try to figure out how to get the best out of those rewards. But be wary. The reward systems, go look at the websites of what they have on their sites before you start to evaluate your purchases and say, you know what, I'll pay a little bit more because I'll get rewards and I'll get something else out of it. That was my logic to there. That way you don't make any big mistakes. All right. So that's one guy. Okay. Right. Not a big fan of them. I'm not a big fan of them at all. At all. That's interesting. The staples are right in here in the middle. That's interesting. How the hell? Why are they stapled like that? That's interesting. Anyway. Dave Knight becomes the Black Knight. Magneto and Toad appearance. All right. One more Kia off my punch list. Happy to have it in my collection. Just don't like the way I end up getting it. All right. So then let's go on to another one. This one is from a place called Goodbye Comics. All right. So, all right. Anytime you have somebody that actually says that they're a goodbye, you want to be cautious. They're a whatnot as well. Okay. I don't think if you're a good buy or a good seller, you should name yourself a good seller goodbye. You should have your customers name you a goodbye or a good seller. Not that yourself. Just like all those jerks that they keep telling you how transparent they are and how good guys they are. If they're really good guys, they wouldn't have to tell you. You would tell them. Anyway, that's a story and a talk for another day. Okay, let's start with this. All right, so they did put invoices in here, so that's positive because that's a pet peeve of mine that I've been having in the past as far as people not putting invoices in there. So this guy actually does put an invoice in here, and then you can put 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. All right, so I see what I pay for everything. All right, got a bunch of stuff from him. So here's my gripe with this guy. Okay, so one of the situations with this guy is that he had stuff in the auctions. He had him starting at a dollar or very low. I don't remember the exact starting points, but you could go pre-bid on them. When he would pull those out and put them up on auction, they were no longer at that dollar. He would set up all different prices. In other words, there might be something that he started for a dollar. And he decided, no, I'm not going to put it up for a dollar. I'm going to put it for $100 and all the free bids that get thrown out. What's the point of having an auction and setting it up ahead of time if you're going to throw out all the original pre-bids? It's kind of like bait and switch, don't you think? I think it's a bait and switch. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe a lawyer out there will tell me. Am I wrong? When you put a certain price on a thing as far as a pre-bid and then you put it on the market at that moment for an actual auction and change up the price 10 times or 100 times what your original pre-bid starting point was, and you race everybody's pre-bids that were there previously, I think that's a little bit of bait and switch. So I called the guy out on it during the auction. And he laughed. He laughed. He's not the only guy that does that. There's a lot of people that do that. I can't stand that. You know, if I'm going to put something as a pre-bid or as an auction start and it's going to say a dollar, no matter what, even if there's five people in the room, I'm going to honor it because that's my reputation. That's my name on the line for doing that. And I'll show you on a few of them how that happened. You put a card in there. Say hello to goodbye. Yeah, all right. Say hello. Okay. All right. There's no thank you in here, by the way. So far. Maybe there's one down the line. Okay, but he likes to say hello. Hey, say hello. Okay, all right. Say hello. Okay. So let me see how these are set up, so I could bring them out in the proper fashion. Okay. Okay, and I'll take out the, I'll put aside the bigger books, and then I'll show you them in a proper order. Okay. Okay. All right. So we got this one. All right. Let's start with this. We got this. This one I end up getting. That's another thing that irks the hell out of me. On a lot of the things, it doesn't tell you how much, what exactly it was. So exactly, this it says single comic book number 3. It doesn't tell you exactly what I'm getting. So if I got the wrong book, I'm fucked. I know I got the right book because this is what I got. For $7, I got Fantastic Four 89. Okay? It's pretty beat to shit, to be honest with you. He didn't exactly say that it was in good shape, but it is beat to shit more than I thought. That's all right. For $7, I still would have bought it because I just needed it as one filler. But this was another one. It was in the auctions for a dollar start, and he automatically decided to make it, I think, $7 start. Why? Why'd you have it for a dollar start when you decided to ignore the pre-bids and make it $7? I don't know. You tell me. He did the same thing with this. Amazing Spider-Man 168. This one actually was listed. See, this one was listed. See? You see how this says Amazing Spider-Man, number one, $7. And then, see, this one says single comic issue. Let me see where it goes. Yeah. So hopefully this shows well. You see that single comic book issue, number three. What book is it? Well, it could be imaginary book. I don't know. Put down what I'm buying. And then this one actually says it. So I have 168. I bought this for $1. $7. And again, there was a starting line on it at $1. I had done a pre-bid on it. He decided to ignore all the pre-bids that were on there and just start at $7. I bought it anyway because I needed a run filler. Same thing happened with this one. Amazing Spider-Man 167. These are in decent shape, actually, believe it or not. 167. So I got 167 and 168. Both for $7 a piece. Let me see. This is another one. This one came under the guise of single book. Single book, okay? Single book, $5. Actually, I think I got the Fantastic Four for $5. Sorry. I got the Fantastic Four for $5. See, that's why it gets confusing with the singles. It doesn't tell you what you're buying. I think I got that for $5 and I bought this for $7. I think he decided, instead of honoring the starting line that he had there, he just started all Amazing Spider-Mans he had for $7 a piece. And again, I got these because, okay? So then he decided he's going to put together a lot of the old amalgam books, okay? And see, that's another thing. He put this one as large comic book lot number one, okay? And I got this for $20. You could tell, I don't know. $20 I bought it just for. Now, I got this for $20, and it had Dark Claw, number one, Lobo the Duck, number one, Bat Thing, number one, Thorion of the New Asgods, number one, Challengers of the Fantastic, number one, Man of War, Super Soldier, number one, okay, Iron Lantern, number one, Generation Hex, number one, Magneto, Magnetic Men, featuring Magneto, number one, JLX Unleashed, number one, and The Exciting X-Patrol, number one, okay, all right, okay. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. This is actually the only one that I think has any kind of value. The other ones are like a couple bucks of itself. This might be like $5, $6, I don't know. I paid $20 for all of them. Basically, a little less than $2 a piece. The reason I got them is because I got them all together. And I just wanted to complete a set of this. Sometimes, like, I know that if I was diligent and I was patient, I could find them in dollar bins one at a time and that kind of thing, or find them in a collection and get them for cheap. I didn't want to, I had them all in one place. I already bought stuff from the other guy. I already got the shipping that was partially paid for. And I said, you know what, let me just get them, at that point. So I got these all together, okay? Then he had a bunch of bigger books that he had up on auction. Now, he had a lot of these books at high sticker prices, really, really high sticker prices, really high sticker prices, okay? When I tell you high, okay? Now, I was not going to pay the sticker price that he had on. Not a chance. And he didn't put these up for auction. He actually decided he was going to try to work out a deal with people that gave him offers. So I started putting offers together, was haggling with him. He had this priced at $80 initially. And this is Teen Titans number 23. And it's the first appearance of Wonder Girl in her new costume. I like it. I just got it because it's a nice little minor key. I kind of collect some of these weirder keys from the Teen Titans run. And I was not going to pay $80 for it. I can promise you I was not going to do that. I know I really didn't want to pay more than $30 for it, more or less. Maybe $35 stretching. Okay? That was my price in my head. All right? So I got that. I showed him that I had interest in there. And then there was another book here that I've been wanting to get, but I didn't want to pay a lot of money for. I just wanted to have it in my collection, but I didn't want to pay a lot of money for it. So that's Fantastic Four, number 45. This is the first appearance of the Inhumans. This thing has gone down a lot over the years. Disney really screwed that one up. He had a $100 sticker price on there. And to be quite honest with you, in the grade that it's in a low grade, not the worst grade, in a low grade, I think $100 is not a horrible thing. But I wasn't going to pay for it. Screw that. Especially after I was annoyed with his whole way of auctioning, I was going to squeeze the hell out of him. There was no way I was going to. Go for there. Let's first of all, before I get into what I find in paper, let's see if I actually have the right book that I. Oh, look at this. You got a split. Okay. All right. So that's not nice. Okay. He didn't mention that it was split, but yeah, he didn't mention that there was a split here. What the fuck? All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. There's no way there's 70 pages in here. I probably counted wrong. It looks complete. It looks complete. But the splitting, that's a lot of splitting. He didn't mention that it was splitting in there. But okay. Okay. So I got this, okay? Second book, the one that he was advertising as beat the shit to hell, was this one. Another copy of Fantastic 445. Okay? Okay. Let's open this one up to see how the innards are of this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Okay, perfect. All the pages are here. Okay. So this one's beat to shit. Staples are in here. Extra staples, you know, special extra staples. It's beat to shit. This is a super low grade, you know, super, super low grade, but I don't mind it. It's a key book. And I knew it was beat to shit when I got it. He said that this was beat to shit. He didn't say this one was as beat to shit as it is, but he did say this one is beat to shit. Okay. He did say that. Okay. So I got this too. Why? Because I was getting one of them. Why not get another one? You know what? Screw this. I'm going to open this one up too, since we're at it. Let's open this up and make sure that all the pages are here. Let's make sure that all the pages are here, because I'm not even good. This one is actually decent. It really, really, it needs a cleaning, definitely a press, but it's a very presentable book. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. It makes me almost feel like this one was pressed, actually, at one point. It still could use a pressing. It still could use a cleaning. But the pages are really, really clean and sharp on the inside. Interesting. Interesting. All right, so here's the thing. We're going back and forth on this thing. He's trying to negotiate the best deal he can on it. We finally came up to the... I told him, listen, I will buy these two. He was trying to bundle these two in a deal. He didn't know that I was interested in this. Excuse me. So I told him, listen, I'll do $80 for the two of them. But if I buy... The two for $80, you gotta sell this to me for $15. So in my head, I could get all three of them for $100 or less than $100. And that was an offer I was giving him that I was not gonna be very flexible on. You know, I almost gave him a take it or leave it kind of a thing. So we went back and forth on a couple of things. Some jackass out of nowhere jumped up and said that he'll do it for $90, these two books. While I was sitting negotiating with him, that's what happens when you're in an auction room and there's multiple people in there. So he's like, all right, I'll run it for 90. Like, you son of a bitch. So instantaneously, I was going to buy for 90 regardless. So instantaneously, as soon as the guy put it up there, I took the bid. I took the first bid. Fortunately, the other guy didn't actually bid against me. So it makes me think either he was trying to bid me up or he just didn't want to go past $90. Okay. But either way, if he did go up there, I'll bid him. I was not going to go to 100 on him. I just refused. So as you can see, I bought that for 90. Now, after I got this, I told him, listen, I told you, I'll buy this if you guys throw the other one. You gotta give me the other copy for $15. And that's what he did. Give me for the other $15. So I got all three of these for 105, okay? I think I still did okay. Oh, I don't know, I'm not happy. I gotta take a good, cleaner look at this. This one's really beat to shit, like a lot more beat to shit than he didn't tell me about all these. I gotta go back to the video, if it's still pre-recorded from him, and actually see if the splits were all mentioned or not. Because this was really, really bad. Like, I didn't expect that. But still, you know, even on a bad day, I would say, in this shape, I think somebody would pay $75 to $100 for it. I think so. I mean, maybe horrible, like, great deal, $50, I don't know, I would think. And this one, I think somebody would pay $30 for it. $30, $35 for it, what I estimated for it. So, and then this, even in shitty shape like this, I think it's $25, $30 book, no matter what. Even if it was incomplete, it's still a big key. So I still think I did okay from it. I'm just not happy with the circumstances of how I bought it. So just a recap, I got a whole bunch of stuff from Goodbye, which I didn't think was a great buy, or maybe not even a good buy, but I got these three keys. I got myself two Fantastic Fours. We got that, and we got the Teen Titans, and let's not forget the Black Knight first appearance that we got over from Going Twice. All right, that's my haul. This is what I got. Like it, love it, I don't know. I'm happy, I don't care, whatever. Thank you, goodbye, thank you.
Worst episode ever.
I'd appreciate your input.
Fuck you, Comic Journey!
Oh, two fingers.
Yeah, we're from England, mate. Fuck you!
What the hell?